President Obama went to Silicon Valley today to call for more cooperation between private companies and the government when it comes to defending against cyber attacks. In the wake of major hacks against health insurer Anthem and Sony Pictures, the president told executives they need to share more information. But today's summit also comes amid growing tensions between tech companies and the administration over privacy and civil liberties, a point the president acknowledged.
In all our work, we have to make sure we are protecting the privacy and civil liberty of the American people. And we grapple with these issues in government. We've pursued important reforms to make sure we are respecting people's privacy as well as ensuring our national security. And the private sector wrestles with this as well.
Several CEOs of top tech companies, including Google, Facebook, and Yahoo, did not attend, reportedly over anger and disappointment about a lack of reform in the president's broad surveillance programs. The revelations about the government's reach are the subject of a documentary nominated for an Academy Award. Jeffrey Brown picks it up from there. Part of our series, The NewsHour Goes to the Movies.
My name is Edward Snowden. I go by Ed. Edward Joseph Snowden's the full name.
The documentary Citizenfour brings us into a Hong Kong hotel room as former National Security Agency contractor Edward Snowden reveals secrets that would make for blockbuster headlines beginning in June 2013. The large-scale collection of phone and internet data by the U.S. government.
Even if you're not doing anything wrong, you're being watched and recorded. And
news organizations would publish stories of a massive database, assembled since 2006 under the Patriot Act, collecting call data from millions of phone company customers and tapping into the central servers of major internet companies. For some, Snowden was a free speech hero. In the film, he explains his decision to eventually make his identity known.
These are public issues. These are not my issues. You know, these are everybody's issues. And I'm not afraid of you. You know, you're not going to bully me into silence like you've done to everybody else. And if nobody else is going to do it, I will. And hopefully when I'm gone, whatever you do to me, there'll be somebody else who'll do the same thing.
But others, including President Obama, called on Snowden to come back to the U.S. and face charges for espionage.
No, I don't think Mr. Snowden was a patriot. So the fact is that Mr. Snowden's been charged with three felonies. If, in fact, he believes that what he did was right, then, like every American citizen, he can come here, appear before the court with a lawyer, and make his case.
Beginning with encrypted emails and then in Hong Kong, Snowden met with and told his story to journalist Glenn Greenwald, then with The Guardian newspaper, and filmmaker Laura Poitras, the director of the Oscar-nominated documentary. I spoke to the two earlier this afternoon.
Welcome to both of you. Laura Poitras, let me ask you, what did you want the film to do that the steady drumbeat of news revelations could not do? Well, why a film?
Well, I mean, as a documentary filmmaker, you know, what I try to do is, you know, it has all the components of journalism. It has to be truthful and factual, but really it's about saying something about bigger issues. So for me, this was looking at the story both of the NSA, but like what individual stories of courage, not just Edward Snowden, but William Binney, other whistleblowers who are coming forward. And it's also very much a film looking at journalism. So as a documentary filmmaker, I want to make something that can be seen and be interesting today and in 10 years from now.
And Glenn Greenwald, we're watching a film in which you are an actor in a real sense. How did you see your role working with Edward Snowden?
I didn't feel like an actor at all. I felt like what I was, which was a journalist pursuing a really big story. And it just so happened that my journalistic colleague, who happens to be a filmmaker as well, filmed it because we had a good sense that this was something significant and important.
The critics of Edward Snowden would look at what you were doing as collaborating with him, in a sense, working with him to bring out this story.
This is a standard accusation that gets made to delegitimize journalism. But what we did was classic journalism. We had a whistleblower come to us with secrets that he thought should not have been concealed, that the public had a right to know, and he asked us to use the standard journalistic process of reporting it. And that's exactly what we did, and we feel extremely good about that.
Laura Poitras, the film plays like a thriller. How did it feel in that room? What was it like with Edward Snowden? Were you surprised when you finally met him?
Yeah, I mean, we didn't manufacture the kind of thriller aspects to it. That actually came with the story. I mean, I started receiving anonymous emails from a stranger making claims of, you know, mass government surveillance, and, you know, and then we met in Hong Kong. So it actually felt very much like a thriller from my perspective. There were a lot of unknowns. So when Glenn and I went, we were very surprised when we met somebody who was much younger than we expected. We expected to meet somebody who was, you know, in his 50s. So it took us a bit of time to adjust to that. The person that we met was somebody who was, you know, incredibly calm in the circumstances that he had put himself in, given the risks he was taking.
Glenn Greenwald, fast forward now. Is there evidence that we can point to that collecting the data has harmed people? Is it the fear of it? Is it the idea of it? Or is there actual harm?
Oh, there's all kinds of harm. I mean, we've been able to report on the targeting of political dissidents, of people who visit websites like WikiLeaks, who have their data tracked, targeting on economic conferences, on the UN, eavesdropping on people while they negotiate trade agreements. But, you know, I think that more broadly, it is the fact that knowing that you live in a surveillance state chills the actions of not just journalists, but human rights activists and political organizers and lawyers and psychologists and, you know, medical professionals, people who need secrecy.
And how do you see Edward Snowden even now?
I see him as somebody who did what we should want people in government and with access to secrets to do, like Daniel Ellsberg, who's widely considered a hero, which is when someone like that discovers something that the public ought to have known about. And he did that knowing that he was putting his life and his liberty in jeopardy. And to me, it's an incredibly admirable act. Democracy depends on having people like Edward Snowden.
But even many people who are glad to know about the information think that he should come back, that he should be tried, that he should pay the price for an act of civil disobedience.
Well, I mean, it's, I guess, pretty easy to say, well, Edward Snowden should just come back and submit to a cage for the rest of his life. But I don't really think that that's his obligation to do. He's been given political asylum. And I think, unfortunately, I mean, Daniel Ellsberg, who did submit to the judicial system in 1972, wrote an op-ed early on in the Washington Post saying, in the United States in the post-9/11 era, if you're accused of national security leaks, it's been proven that your conviction is virtually guaranteed and that you do not get a fair trial. And he said Edward Snowden is absolutely right to have sought asylum in another country because his political rights would be abused rather than protected.
Laura Poitras, since the revelations have come out, there's been a lot of talk of reforms, calls for reforms from the president, from Congress, from tech companies. Do you see any changes that have come from Snowden's revelations?
We're seeing a lot of changes happening in the tech companies. I mean, I think that the disclosures have created an awareness of the need for privacy that they know that customers are going to want. So we've seen a lot of changes happening there. I mean, we see that, you know, Google is using encryption of its servers when it was disclosed that the NSA was sort of tapping into their servers. So there, we've seen those kinds of changes. What we've seen less of is government changes. And then, you know, also, I mean, Glenn and I have been reporting internationally. I think internationally there's a shift of consciousness around the threat and dangers of the kind of indiscriminate mass surveillance that is disclosed.
And what do you want people or companies or governments to take from the film? Do you want some action from the film?
I make films because I really believe in, you know, the power of communicating. And so how people then use that information, that's up to them. So I do hope that it raises awareness and maybe takes an issue that's abstract and makes it a bit more, you know, human or visceral so you can understand the consequences.
All right, the film is Citizenfour. Laura Poitras, Glenn Greenwald, thank you both very much.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Thank you.